Students, the next topic is development of anther. See the process. A very young anther is represented by only a group of parenchymatous cells covered by epidermis. Soon it becomes four-lobed. Now, some hypodermal cells form archosporial initial or archosporial cells. They have a dense cytoplasm with a prominent nucleus. Now, archosporial cell divides to form two cells, outer primary parietal cell and inner primary sporogenous cell. Now, the parietal cell undergoes several anticlinal and periclinal division to form 3 to 5 wall layers, that is endothecium, middle layers and tapetum. Now, the primary sporogenous cell divides to form sporogenous cell, which further divide to form pollen mother cells or microspore mother cells. See, first all the cells are similar, then some hypodermal cells differentiate to form archosporial cell. It forms, divides to form outer primary parietal cell, inner primary sporogenous cell divides to form pollen mother cells, and these wall layers, see, outer epidermis, then endothecium, then 3 to 5 middle layers, and the innermost layer is tapetum. Now again I am repeating, first all the cells are parenchymatous and similar, then some cells differentiate to form archosporial initial, then it divides to form outer primary parietal cell, then primary inner primary sporogenous cell. Then it forms sporogenous cell. Then it forms microspore mother cell. And primary parietal cell forms wall of anther. Thank you.